Okay, afternoon y'all, it's Renegade Biker 24, and today's Motovlog, I like to start off by titling this probably The Battle of the Nerds. The Battle of the Nerds, which is me versus this other guy by the name of Disney Hook on one of the Facebook pages that I'm going to list on this vlog, and I'll even list where it's at. Now the guy seems to think that there is an individual who's looking for a cheap laptop to do vlogging, editing, and all that on. Well, it first started out with me suggesting an AMD processor. And the person was looking for something that was the $300 to $400 range. And so I listed what Walmart has for an AMD. Well, he wasn't satisfied with that because he apparently seems to think that the Intel i5 is a lot better processor because the AMD has this APU, which in a laptop is pretty much required, at least in the AMDs, and I'll give him that, because that's the way AMDs are. Now the problem with that is he's saying because they have a heating problem. Well, of course they have a heating problem because of the little fan. Now the little fan that's in most laptops is not enough to prevent the computer from overheating. It really is not, and this is my opinion. Because you're going to end up having to get a cooling pad, which in this respect means that it's like, you end up having to spend maybe $20, $30, I don't know, depends on wherever you buy it from. If you buy it from Best Buy or wherever. But the problem is that you're going to need a cooling pad. Well, this cooling pad is supposed to reduce the amount of heat that the laptop gives off. And when a person puts a laptop in their lap, hence the name laptop, or even a notebook, which where's most notes usually being taken is on a person's lap. So that'll cause the processor to overheat. And so then you don't have a problem with, or so then you have actually have a problem with the processor overheating. So what is the one way of doing that is the cooling pad. Well, like I said, some people can't afford it. After they end up buying the laptop, and then of course there's the warranty that goes along with it, and all this other kind of stuff that goes along with it, and that affects the price in of itself. Now then, of course, the other things that are involved in this problem is the price of the laptop itself. So now you've got just the laptop itself, and then you've got the warranty that goes along with that, but then that's a separate issue altogether. So now you've got all this, now you've got the government involved. Now when that computer breaks, and it will eventually break because of software requirements or these updated stuff that, as people can tell over the years, yeah, it's been like that, where technology keeps changing. and it changes more often than this Arkansas weather here. So now you got all of this stuff. Then when that computer breaks, where does that end up going? Well, some people will probably end up throwing it in the trash. But the problem with that is the U.S. government will not allow you to do that in certain states or certain provinces or you know, wherever. And that becomes a problem because now you got environmental concerns. Now, this kind of goes along with what my company is going to try and do, which is recycle all the computer parts and the components down to their component level. So, anyway, so now you've got all of this happening, and then you get where most of this stuff ends up on a ship going overseas to China, India, Pakistan, even over in Africa, where people don't know what they're doing when it comes to the recycling of the computer. They'll burn the useless parts. They'll create a problem with the land, with the air, with the soil. And most of this is evident in the video that I will also link in this video of it's called Exporting Harm, the High-Tech Trashing of Asia, which, where's most of that stuff going? So after a computer is considered outdated, and it usually is outdated by the time that you get it home, where does it end up going? Well, it ends up going on that container ship. Or at least 80% of it does. Now, in today's market, probably 90 to 100%. Because it's easier to export it than it is to actually tear it apart and recycle it for its components, which is stupid. So, anyway, so the guy seems to think that, well, that is not the problem, and that I don't know what I'm talking about, and this and that, and that, well, do I speak English? Ha! Ha! I do speak English. I don't think he's following along. Anyway, so now you've got the whole problem of disposal of it, but that also affects the market price. Now, what also affects the market price is the regulation or deregulation of certain components or computers or this and that, because the government makes it so damn freaking confusing, it's just not even comprehensible on how the government makes it like this. But it is. So instead of clear defined rules of recycling all of the damn components in the computer industry, they just send it all overseas. They say, hey, let's have them do it. When all of this can be recycled with my company, in which recycling plastic, aluminum, tin, platinum, palladium, steel, metal, all of this can be recycled, even the neodymium, which is what's used on the which is what's used to hold the read write heads on a PETA drive. So this guy seems to think that has nothing to do with affecting the brute market forces of what is regulated by the governments. And I mean governments because it goes through so many different channels, from if the computer board is made in either Texas, California, China, Taiwan, wherever the hell it's made. But that's just the way it is. But what are your opinions about this? I'd like to hear it in the comments section. And if you all can, like I said, please participate in the discussion I have with this individual, because I really don't think the guy actually knows what he is talking about when it comes to the computer industry as a whole. But anyway, that's what I've got to say about that certain situation. It's a passion of mine to recycle every computer out there, no matter what it is or where it's coming from, either car, motorcycle, TV, computer, cell phone, whatever. Because all of that has precious metals in it, and all that can be recycled, and all that can be reused instead of draining this earth's natural resources, in which, by the way, computer chips are made of sand. So anyway, like I said, that's all I've got to say about that. But anyway, y'all, this is Renegade Biker 24, and I am on my 2014 Honda CTX 1300 Deluxe motorcycle, and I will talk to you all later.